Hello everyone, 8-bit days a week here, and I'm gonna play Super Puzzle Fighter 2 Turbo on the PlayStation Classic. Let's see. I played this before on the a few times on the arcade, but mostly I actually got like a PC port of this. That's where I mainly played it. And this is actually not one of the titles you'd think of when you think PlayStation and Capcom. I mean, they did get Resident Evil here, that's nice, but Super Puzzle Fighter 2 doesn't just scream PlayStation title. I'm sure you know what I mean. Would probably think of Street Fighter Alpha 3 or 2, or you know, actually any Street Fighter title would be a better choice than this one, or even just the Gem Fighters Minimix, which is graphically looks like this one, but it's an actual fighting game, or even just a sequel of the Resident Evils would be nice. Or Mega Man, any of the Mega Man, we have Mega Man 8, the X series, 4 or 5, 6, no, not 5 and 6, just 4. And then there's Legends, and Sean Bond. Now those are PlayStation, I mean Capcom titles that you'd think of when you think Capcom and PlayStation. But anyway, probably needed variety, and I'll take what we can have, I'll just try to enjoy what I have, what we can get. Unfortunately, it could have been better. So yeah, I do remember that just sometime last year, this had like an Android port. And it was actually interesting because it featured more characters from more Capcom games as opposed to just Street Fighter and Darkstalkers here. It had Dante, Mega Man X, but I guess it didn't perform as much as Capcom had hoped, I'm not sure, because they just suddenly cancelled it. Very abrupt, even. That's too bad. Anyway, not much going on here. I couldn't say Tetris clone, but it's a puzzle game where you have to line up blocks of the same colors, and you're gonna destroy those gems by using the circular, like this one I have right now for the blue one. So I put it there and it goes kaboom, and doing so would leave an attack like that on your opponent. And that's it. That's how you play this game. It's fun, especially if you have someone to play with, second player. And at least this one plays like the NTSC version. I mean, if it wasn't, I guess we wouldn't really notice it that much. It's just a simple puzzle game. I mean, there's not much really movement or twitchy controls, unlike, say, a fighting game. Ooh, yeah, maybe that's the reason why they chose this one instead of any other fighting game. They might have included like a PAL version once again, which would really screw up, call it, timings. Okay, incoming. Alright, I have to rally back here. I'm making too much mistakes there. Alright, game over. So, not as easy as I remember. I can't recall who I really used to main here. I think it's Shianko. So this also had numerous ports. I do believe there's a GBA version, and I think there's also like a Xbox Live or PSN port. I didn't really play those, so I don't know how it compares. I think it's like an HD version or something. But to be honest though, if you remove the Capcom characters here, I'd probably not be even interested in this game. The big draw is that it's like a mini crossover of sorts with between Capcom characters, and I'm a big fan of Capcom characters, of course. And yeah, that's actually just the draw for me. For this one, when it comes to puzzle games, I would rather be playing Tetris, of course, Puyo Puyo, Bust a Move. Those are my kind of puzzle games. Not to say that this game is bad. It's fine for what it is. It's just not my kind of. I mean, the. It's unique, yes. I mean, it's not a clone, not like a direct clone of some other puzzle game, in the sense that you just have to line up things, because most of the drop-down puzzle games are usually like that, just line up things and they all go away. But at least this one isn't like that. This is more like Puyo Puyo, but the attack, so to speak, is not as direct, whereas in Puyo Puyo, once you line up the similar colors, it all goes away right away. Alright, I hope I can come back from this. Too late. When the Android version came out, I actually dabbled with it for a few months that it was actually released, mainly because Mega Man X is there, and I do like the Mega Man X series that much. I really wish they chose X4 if they don't want to include another fighting game, since there's Tekken and Toshinden already. Done here. I'm not sure how I can come back from this. that's just basically it. My thoughts on this game, it's okay, but it's not a worthy inclusion, especially if you're only just gonna have 20 titles preloaded on this system. In short, there are lots of better choices from Capcom's library of PlayStation games. But if you love puzzle games, I'm sure you're gonna be happy to have this included. And yes, it's the NTSC version. And yeah, I'll take it from here. This is 8-Bit Days a Week. I should stop calling myself that. This is Channel 8-Bit Days a Week, and please do leave comments, like, dislike, subscribe, and all that. Thanks for watching.